have been scholarly students of the Word of God. Uh-huh. Now, I have to say that in case somebody missed this. I know you were here listening to the history, but I want you to miss the connection here. All right, you with me now?
All right.
So therefore, if these people did scholarly, they had to be, and I'm going to lay it out there, what Psalm would have said for the last, I know, 200 years, they had to have been white.
Yeah.
Why'd they have to be?
Right.
If they lived in Northern Africa.
You couldn't be white.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Somebody listen. All right, sir. Amen. 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 Couldn't be.
Amen.
Couldn't be. Not possible. All right, unless you relocated there from somewhere else. Oh, yeah. Amen. And it takes a generation for the skin tone to change from what I've learned through history. All right, now check this out. Augustine, even though this discussion was debated about him, many of these debates overshadowed the great work that he did for the church. He was recognized as being the father of theology. The father of theology, Augustine, when writing in Rome, boldly stated that he was one of us.
Yeah.
Meaning, meaning that he was white in skin color.
Uh-huh.
But how could he have been when he was in Northern Africa, which is where the church started, in that area? All right, now let me give an example of that. The late Dr. Marsha Kiba. How many of you knew Brother Marsha Kiba? I know some people here knew him, heard him preach. Anybody who was baptized by Brother Kiba? Anybody? Okay. All right. Anybody's family member was baptized by Brother Kiba? Anybody's family members? All right. One. All right. Now, I was not privileged to know Brother Kiba. I learned a lot about him later on, and I got to know his wife, Sister Kiba, when I first started preaching. I got to know her. She would come be in the audience, and I was like a little boy in a candy store. I was just elated, man. Eyes big and wide. I'm like, Sister Kiba's in the audience. You know, and I'm like, I'll make sure I preach this sermon good. Sister Keeble and all that. I know y'all do it good anyway, but I'm making a point now. Because I'm a young preacher, and I'm trying to make sure I look good in front of Sister Keeble. And she didn't come here, everybody preach.
Amen.
So I was elated. And so just to think of what all Brother Keeble did. But the point is, on one occasion, Brother Keeble and the late Brother A.M. Burton. How many of you have heard of Brother A.M. Burton? All right. Now, Brother A.M. Burton, who was the founder of the Life and Casualty Insurance Company, Brother Burton, who financed Brother Kiba around the world to preach the gospel, because he wanted the gospel to be spread, and he wanted to find somebody who could reach both blacks and whites and whoever would listen, regardless of their skin tone color, and therefore he put Brother Kiba on payroll and paid Brother Kiba, and Brother Kiba went all over the world, and did he come? He came to Third Street?
Yeah.
I thought he did. Came to Third Street maybe more than once to preach the word of God. Well, on one occasion, Brother Kiba and Brother Burton was on the stage, and they were on stage at this particular church, and while it was a black congregation, all right? And while they were there, Brother Burton leaned over to Brother Kiba and said, "You know, Brother Kiba, we're the only black people in here." Now, you can appreciate Brother Burton, yes. For those of you who don't know, Brother Burton was white. All right. Now, and therefore, that let you know he had been around black people so much, he felt at home, he felt as if he was black. He didn't even catch his own self. Amen. I'm doing something he had to explain so everybody can catch up. All right, everybody got that? All right, now let me move on with Augustine. Augustine being a student of Carthage where blacks reside. Here it is. Augustine being a student of Carthage where blacks reside. Concluded that he must have been black.
Amen.
Why? Because black folk hung out with black folk in college. Seeing that he lived, he was a resident of that region. Alright? Now this was a black nation in Northeast Africa.
Amen.
There's no record of any white people originating from Northeast Africa.
Amen.
Now you say, why is that so important? Let me go back and read what I said earlier. Augustine was recognized as the most scholarly theologian of Bible.